the scale past 45. So SNY just hits this awkward timing where it's like, yeah, it feels good at like 20 minutes, but you're going to start thinking about scaling outside of that by 30. While Echo Saber's like, it's right at that sweet timing where it's like, it gives me my early game transition. That's power to.
Running for the 5 seconds back, Kevin. What do you itemization overall about the tournament?
Reserve stuff time. For sure. Yeah, let's say things like the Midas build.
OGs turn to ban.
Itemization stuff to be figured out still.
Minuses as a whole, right? Like across the board, there have been a lot of them.
Yeah.
I think with the addition of talents into the game now, it makes a lot more sense to kind of push yourself past the level of 16.
So before you're like, oh, I'm 16. I don't care.
Yeah, before
what
it's
happens.
Like you wouldn't want to be a higher level because remaining. Give up more gold and you give up more experience, give up death timer, everything. So now it makes sense to get to higher levels because we have such amazing talents at level 20 and level 25 that kind of almost change your hero.
Even those those level 10 experience gain, like Tusk, for example, I don't really think he's a Midas hero, but when you have plus 40% experience gain, like that Midas looks really good because you get level 10, you have that Midas, you immediately get to level 15, you get 150 extra damage on the snowball. That's still value when you...
Reserve time.
Maybe the talents have changed. We are into the draft. Are we going to see the same bands? That's the first question. To come to and
Naga's already gone.
Did newbie attack this? Do they just go?
They're just gonna be left.
Naga was the problem because it's the only split pusher in the game that can actually kind of win you the game because it still gives you really good team fight potential. Right. Most of the other split pushers aren't really a thing right now.
It's good that newbie is kind of isolated. Puts the spoiler on a complete draft. It makes them change.
Flying the Enigma as easily. He's actually have to go like Blink Dagger early rather than just Midas into B.
Most likely to see like Centaur Magnus instead out of S4. Yeah. The Enigma seems. I wouldn't be surprised if they go back to it later.
I think, yeah.
Newbies turn to pick.
In which case,
protecting defensive supports? Yes?
Defensive supports. I think Lifestealer is also still very value when you're. The Magnus, because you're talking about like, okay, you're talking about more melee heroes if you're running a Magnus. And it's also good.
OG's turn to pick.
Lifestealer
Mag. I was going to say, we go back to G now, flip around and take the Lifestealer.
Has No-Till played a lot of Lifestealer?
10 seconds remaining.
I feel like it's not a hero that they've turned to. Very much, if at all.
5 seconds remaining.
I feel like it fits his playstyle, but it hasn't been the hero that they picked up. Enigma. Way more Terra Blades.
Okay. Wow. They're going to lock in the Enigma. They like the Enigma in the first game. Hey. Even without the Naga this time around, they go with it. And we're going to see the Monkey King.
The last time that OG did, they basically jungled. Jarex was off lane sort of position. Just gave. So he actually accelerated quite a bit. On a lot of other. The lane slightly different monkey.
I was thinking last game, what if they took Rubick instead of that lion?
Maybe
they would have had a little bit more struggle with illusions, and maybe they wouldn't have been able to deal with Storm Spirit quite as well, but it would have solved that kind of like refresher Enigma problem. Now Rubick can just steal the black hole and black hole Enigma, and all of a sudden Enigma is just going to die, most likely.
I think this is one of the rare times viable support. Feels so bad right now, unless you're versus him. I was talking to who was
I like him.
You still like him?
I've liked him ever since like the addition of talents.
I was telling the story. It was like I was playing a pub against Bulba, and he messaged me afterwards. He was like, "Don't pick Rubick. That hero is bad right now." And I was like, "You know, I feel like it's
maybe
bad.
He was just putting
soft. Maybe. It's the Rubick. It's not you. It's the Rubick. I swear." But no, it just like feels not very impactful. Like all of these other scaling supports, excluding this point, right, where Rubick is scaling because he's versus an enemy.
Got a level 10 GPM talent. I know it's only 60.
It's only 60.
But I'm telling you,
you might as well take the 50 damage.
No. It makes a difference. You just walk around. You let all your carries farm, and if you die a couple times, you get that blink dagger that a lot of position fives don't really get.
All right, well, I'm gonna tell Bulba's a dumbass because I'm not gonna argue with.
Nah. Bola is a very smart tactician, and I look forward to.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
The obvious. Who does newbie get the first pick? Banning. And
I think the problem
OG first.
For newbie is that they can't actually all of the laning phase match up well against Airblade, Lifestealer.
Bad with a.
Because he's gonna have well. Kiting issues, right?
Is that a no-tell hero?
Not really,
good.
No.
Another.
I feel like we're just making up no-tell heroes right
That's
now.
That's true.
Oh, come on, he can play a lot of stuff.
But will he?
Probably.
See, I read somewhere last week he's. Why isn't the world a hero's played in pro game?
Probably because he's also played a bunch of roles and he's played
and
a.
And he's been
here
forever. Yeah.
Newbies turn. There's like a certain set of like. 8 heroes that are no-tail heroes, and I feel like they've been recycled for about 2 years now, or ever since he's carry, which isn't a bad thing.
Yeah, that's true.
He is very, very good at those.
Oh, just realized that the sound serves banned because they want to open Enigma.
That makes sense.
It must mean they're not scared of the Warlock, is what that. I thought sound serve the laning. The hero that contributes better to the lane than Warlock does, but still counters block.
Yeah, we did see how late game you're just like, okay, I have a refresher and you don't. Alchemist.
In the previous game, they, what was it, like third or fourth picked Enigma?
Yeah.
And it gave them, gave newbie way less options to kind of counter the Enigma, which is, I think is worrisome for OG, taking Enigma first two and allowing newbie to really just kind of set up for him.
Yeah, as the game ended, I thought for sure, they're going to ban Enigma second phase.
Might have Lifestealer right here for newbie again.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah.
Do you want to do it against an Enigma?
Seemed
like it had some trouble.
Remaining.
It's kind of good, but it also had issues.
It had a little bit of trouble, but I think that they're going to be better prepared for the Black Hole this game. And Lifestealer was still putting in quite a lot of work. Even, like, that wasn't against a Naga, too. Naga's a tough matchup for Lifestealer. Yeah.
That's why EG were just, like, first picking it. It's a day two group stage.
Yeah, a lot of teams have first pick in Lifestealer. It's one of the few carries that you can get away with it, I think.
Oh, they take the Aerostat instead.
I like that better. It's a lot more effective at killing Alchemists. Like, Lifestealer's good, but once you have Mantis style, you just jump out of open wounds.
Yeah.
Chase problems, so Ursa can just actually kill within about 2 or 3 stops.
Could be a potential mid matchup as well.
Yeah, that's a good point. Played against that.
Gives you a
the other
threat. I saw.
It was not a fun time.
Yeah. You looked
I was
very
like, oh,
unhappy.
Level 2 up. Go jungle. Time to jungle, guys.
Oh, I'd like that a lot. Mid Ursa, and then put something like hard carry in any safe lane, perhaps Morphling.
I like the Morphling.
Most likely going to see Fly's hero right here. I don't know. I don't know what he really likes against Ursa.
Centaur.
Up against, yeah, he's up against Centaur as well. Might be helpful to have a little bit more lockdown.
I didn't do that on purpose, but there it is.
Safe. It's a safe pick. They seem to love the hero.
Yep.
They'll have lots more in mind. I just feel like the coolest thing about Visage as a hero concept is that if somebody jumps on you and you're a support, okay, they can silence you, they can hex you, but you always have defensive mix with your birds. That's a really nice thing about the heroes. So
you can peel for yourself.
It's kind of self-sufficient.
Reserve time. Also a nice Roshan scouter.
Yeah,
for this
exactly. That's stuff that OG all likes.
I think, like, most of the Chinese teams, whenever they've been dealing with Alchemists, they usually don't like putting pressure on themselves to end the game early and instead just try and scale. But I feel like the Ursa says that, like, we actually are going to try, like, deal with the Alchemist early and we're going to actually get a 4 position at.
See, there.
I mean, I don't think there was any other carry that could
actually. And it's really
like
smart of them to fourth pick it because it's a very possible ban. And they're probably Jerex is laughing because they probably predicted it. And they were like, okay, we'll ban Warflint.
10 seconds
newbie,
remaining.
Faith, TI champion, too smart.
5 seconds remaining.
The last two bans here, newbie looking for support. OG is going to be looking for carry.
So, Peter, if you're a newbie, do you want a 4 position that kind of roams and puts a lot of pressure on Alchemist early, or do you feel like with the Morphling pickup, you can try and play a little bit more of a scaling game and pick up 4 position scales later?
I think you want to scale later. I think Ursa is going to lay some hands on Alchemist in the mid lane. So Alchemist is going to have to retreat to the jungle very, very early.
You've already got your early game covered between Sitar, Ursa, and Rubick. So what are the best four positions that really scale for this game?
I don't know. I don't have an answer for it. There's too many.
Too many options. Romish that has lockdown.
Yeah, Newbie has a ton of options. I think for OG, my one concern for them right now is I think that they have a lot of potential to be rushed down in these team fights.
10 seconds
like if
remaining.
Newbie comes in initiating very, very quickly, their only kind of peel is at Enigma Black Hole, and he might be really forced and rushed to do it, which is going to make stealing Black Hole incredibly easy for Rubick.
OG's
turn to pick.
Underrated
hero. Okay.
Alchemist is going to have some real problems in the mid lane now.
I don't know if Monkey King can off that one.
Yeah, Whisper from Monkey King. I was asking for that in the group stage.
Yeah, it was touted as a...
Hey, listen.
Now, and we've got an OD as a last pick as well. So, very quickly, gents, which way do you like this one, Purge?
I gotta go with OG. I think the fight's pretty good. They can save allies. I like it.
Okay.
I don't think Newbie will make the same mistakes twice. This time around, they've got the early game lineup that should be able to rush OG. Same mistakes they did in game one.
Rush down from Newbie. I think they're going to take it. We're going to have a game three.
All right. Okay. Opinions abound. Obviously, first game was black hole laden. Are we headed for a same second game? Let's find out as we head back to our comment team of Melini and Toby Wong.
Well, I do hope, Red, we get to a game three, mainly because I want to watch these guys play more Dota. Game number one was absolutely brilliant. A perfect start to the playoffs for DAC. Game number two comes around. The panel was actually along the same line of thoughts as you, Ben. It's a Newbie early push kind of style to keep OG down.
They have a problem, though, trying to find the Alchemist, because now they're doing Alchemist safe lane, or Noto will be playing the Alchemist. So how do you actually contest the safe lane? Normally, you deal with Alchemist by pressuring him in lane. Ursa versus Alchemist is a very Ursa-favored matchup. It's great for Ursa, but I don't know if they're going to put Ursa in the offlane. Possibly.
It would seem like one of those risks, but it wouldn't be something unusual to Newbie. No strangers to running an aggressive offlane and leaving KP up in the safe lane, but then how does that make all the other matchup work up? And is that really what you want to do, like, with your hero? Like, you should look at that timing where you can attack directly into OG.
That's what they wanted to do. I think it's going to be similar to last game in that they want to invade the jungle very early on. And I think this game they actually drafted way better against the Black Hole because they have multiple ways to actually prevent the people from dying in case they do get Black Hole. They have Relocate out, straight. Rubick null field is not great, but he can't steal the Black Hole. And Centaur Axe is also pretty decent. So, multiple ways. Also, if you go full Agi on Morph, you'll take like 5 damage from Midnight Pulse.
Sick. that's the way
the
to
counter.
Touch it. Yep. Obviously, the most strongest late game counter in the game now, Morphling against the Enigma.
And then on the flip side, you have potentially, what, like 3 Midnight Pulses at once?
Mm-hmm.
You cast Midnight Pulse, you
have the one
cast Black Hole, and then you refresh, and you Midnight Pulse again, and then you Black Hole. Oh my god, there's 3 Midnight Pulses.
You were actually commenting on it during game number one, the fact that S4 somehow managed to get like 2 Midnight Pulses almost perfectly on top of each other, so you didn't realize you actually had 2 inside that Radiant jungle fight.
Yeah, the cast animation is like, it's very nondescript. It's just, he's just like, you know, it does a little wave of his hands. Oh, I'm just gonna do this thing that kills all your HP. And it's very good versus the strength-based Centaur, not so great versus other heroes, though, but life-based damage, so skills.
All right, so Newbie are currently being watched by the Red Pawn Courier, which may just happen to be a hero and not just being a courier snipe, but KP will take the route.
Joys of being 350 move speed courier. Every Monkey King's dream.
Surprisingly, they don't actually do anything to really contest the Centaur. Notail didn't go up for the bounty rune. He just sits on bottom lane, trying to body block it up, and actually ends up missing melee creep. So, Red Paul, most powerful courier in the game, as we can see right now.
It would be super easy for them to contest. They didn't actually know the lane, so like a Whisper Ursa can easily chase down an Ursa level 1. So they don't want that to happen. Worth sacrificing the bounty rune for that. So they will aggro, but not with the Ursa. Ursa will be one-on-one versus the Enigma up top, and they currently have the Rubick and the Wisp down here to contest Flying Company.
And that's some really good warning down from Newbie too. So the Sentry would have blocked the cant there. Observe what they placed, they did under the cover of smoke.
Ooh.
So even though OG had their own Observer Ward there, they don't actually know that Nubi got their own down.
One of the things I like most about No-Tail is he's not greedy. A lot of carry players are greedy, they go Midas whenever they can. This dude has a spray at level 1 because he knows he's getting contested. How great is that?
You gotta sort it out.
You gotta win the lane. If you don't win the lane, you're just gonna be stuck trying to catch up all game. And he's trying his best to actually win the lane. So, not skilling up Bounty at level 1, sometimes completely necessary when you expect this from the draft from Nubi.
So, who do you actually like? Like, Nubi are running this IO as well as Rubick. Now, Rubick has been renowned for not having as much effect, unless it's with like a Juggernaut spin kind of combination, so it's not easy to do as much until he hits a higher level. So you get that that level 2 Fade Bolt to do some work. How does that really match up against a hero like the Monkey King, for example, who's going to just be bouncing around all the time? Fly, who also needs to have his earlier levels.
Well, I don't think Monkey King is that great on Try and Try because you can't. You're great again in like 2-on-1 situations because you can just 1-on-1 versus all Lofalina and Jingu Mastery can crush into that. But you can't actually right click that often here. His arm is really, really low. He's going to be trading a lot of height versus these heroes. And then you have to worry about the lift and the stomp. So Rubick doesn't do that much damage on his own, but when you pair it with Hooks on the Double Edge, things can get real rough real fast.
And this top lane matchup should be easy enough for the Ursa, even though obviously Enigma's going to be taking a lot of experience off the lane.
Yeah, that's no fun.
Yeah.
Getting a range creep denied.
But you can't even like zoom him out. Like, you want to run at him with phase boots, you go for a quick clap, it's not going to do much because then the Enigma is going to stay on the shrine and bounce up over on the tree line.
I don't think
that's intentional.
Actually, he got a self. He kept the self going. That was intentional. For some reason, I thought he was trying to set up with the Monkey King, but what are you going to do with level 1 Monkey King? Nothing.
Anna's not had the easiest time to start with. He was actually trying to last hit underneath his tower, and the only levels that was almost impossible for him. So we actually watched him miss like 2 or 3 last hits under a tower before.
Yeah, SCCs do very well on lane. Normally you'll see Wisp paired with Morphling in the mid lane because they wanted the Wisp in the off lane. So that's going to make the mid lane way weaker. But Morphling 1-on-1 is not the best.
Bottom lane, there's the first blood is Fly. He'll be brought down by Nubi. Home stomped and controlled.
Man, the lights in the arena are going crazy. First blood for Nubi, everything
China blue. China number 1! That's what it's all about!
That was cool. I was like, maybe they're gonna like do it on stream, just like blue flag. I wanna kinda check out the Chinese picture, but
it's just the crowd, man. It's the crowd. Alright, so
Hoshi still has really good CS. 17 and 11.
Yeah.
Flying, just like, I'm gonna get more XP in the jungle, but he's looking for to get off a really good start.
It's a trade-off though, right? Like, it's the fact that Yarkmus is gonna get some farm down the bottom lane. So his money is gonna start to roll in. Yeah, you've still got KP getting some good levels, but it's the trade-off. So both off laners are getting really good. They want Jira, he's now gonna jump in. Then you got that slow on the KP. KP needs to hold up for a little bit more space, but this won't work. Soul Sculpture from Fly, the damage is just too much. And Jirax looking to beat through Fate a little bit harder. Can't get the full stacks up, and they will get the kill on the offlane. So offlane is getting everything they want, apart from the death on KP.
Pretty greedy play from Fate. You try to lift the Visage so you can catch hold of something, but he was already dead by this. Like, it was almost already connected by the time he lifted. Maybe lifting the melee and stunning one of them would have maybe saved him. He could have at least fogged on the right side.
There's that IO combination you're talking about, just slipping into it.
Yeah, it's not a lane that Morphling should win on his own. So they definitely need the backup from him. So Morphling doesn't have to invest as much in regeneration and CS. He's actually beating the OD and CS.
Oh, here we go again. Pick up for a back down. Homestone double edge. Is there enough damage? The Aqua still fighting up his own acid spray, but it's not damage to KP. Fate will lose his life. Even if he didn't die right there, G-Rex is passing him through the rear. And it's KP who is now on the run. Needs to get back to the shrine, which he'll be able to do so. And the Tranquil Boots can do the heal unless he wants to be a little bit quicker and just try and trick him.
They're still losing a lot, despite killing.
Oh, that's real trouble for him. S4's gonna fall down. IO, great rotation, and you don't see on the ball. Actually, this blue cloud around him, and the convergence almost killing him off. He's getting back to the tower, but Kaka, he'll tether back down again. He knows he's okay. And not getting the extra bomb.
Did he get the bottle refill on top?
Yeah, he did.
That's tough. That's another life for them. Ooh, immediate smoke after this. So it looks like a similar build coming up from Enigma. The Arcane early. I wonder if he goes for Greaves this game. Probably not. I don't really see anything for Greaves off. And I don't think they're going to be 5-maining that much because of the Alchemist.
He'd probably only do it if he had to, like, be efficient on his item slots. Because he's still a main carrier, right? Like, unless he can do that work. But he's falling in the lane. Hannah is the 3-on-1 at the bottom. There's no real support. Courier was coming in with something, but it's already too late.
That bottle reveal actually, like, made a big deal there because you don't expect the Wizard to be topped off. And Wizard isn't going to tether in with, like, 200 HP. He would just die. So, but that was a big play by the Rubick coming in there. And they will secure themselves a 6-minute rune. They are going double bottle too. I see some core players and Wisp players that like are really against the double bottle in the mid lane if you have a Wisp. But I think on Morphling it makes a lot of sense because you're when you're like Agi morphing in base, it just takes you forever to heal up. That's such a nuisance when you play Morphling. It's just healing in base.
Here, I bet his life when he goes away from like that. Posturing against Anna. Full tri-lane's back up bottom lane for Nubi again, and this is when Monkey King has actually left in the lane, so he's just abandoned and gone into the jungle. And it's Monkey King who's trying to hide in the tree lines to the right of the safe lane. Needs some experience. He really wants to find the farm, however, so he can at least finish up some phase boots. But Nubi understands there's only one hero down there as just a support hero and the perfect Radiant scan. Faith and Karka are moving over. It's a little bit earlier than the 8-minute rune. This is forcing a rotation to come in, and it's Turex. He's off the bottom lane, jumps further down. Remember, there's still no bounty rune to fight over the top off. With Fly rotating in, they can potentially pick up one of these supports. They turn their attention towards Karka with the stun and Soul Assumption. Karka will be punished.
Maybe too predictable by Nubi, doing exactly the same move that he did last game. Smokes into the jungle, plays wards, and then try and get a gank during nighttime.
Their advantage is the ward circle, which went down from OG's in the wrong spot. Their thinking is over on the cliff side, but it's actually watching the bounty rune, so their sentry wards can be misplaced. Oh, here they go again. Waveform forward. No tower picked up. Wants to go on the run. The tether out as well. They have enough damage. It's SC, who will take the kill. Sentry ward was placed just a little bit too late. They understand the observer ward is there, but the damage is done. The alchemist is down.
They'll have Stampede pretty soon too, so they can keep up the pressure on the Alchemist. Morphling doing very well in terms of CS, still above the OD. Ursa, wonder when he's going to start making moves.
Oh, make a break for the trees, Jirax. KP's trying to cut his way through. If he can quality play down the tree, he'll do it. But the Wisp Spirit Ball trying to reveal, having to go deeper, just bouncy.
You know, I was looking at Dota Buff, and I think Wisp has one of the highest win rates versus Monkey King. And I think a lot of it is because of the tree breaking. And the flying vision that he not really flying vision, but vision that he reveals with the ball to the edge of the hero.
Yep.
But, I mean, if you had a theory craft monkey counters, you would pretty much never think of it.
Well, the first ones which were coming up was like, was it Beastmaster? Like, you get the flying hawk, you get like unobstructed vision from Nightstalker or Coddle. Like,
yeah, Coddle
was probably one of the more common pickups we saw against him during the group stage.
Batrider, Timber, those are the ones that normally people think of to kill the trees, but Wisp is not one that really comes to mind.
But Wisp is apparently fine during this tournament. I don't know if it's like how many times he's been picked in this tournament, but I think this was one of the first ones I've seen.
I like the Wisp pickup here a lot because it allows us to keep pressing the outputs without having to back off. Like you want to be able to kill a counter pressure, get a kill, you know, whatever, heal up, and then keep going again. It's also pretty good at dealing with Acid Spray too when you're trying to siege towers. The stain's a very big issue when you're getting cooled down with Acid Spray. And
they're coming for another kill. It's going to be Jirax to pick him up with a teleport. He's just dragging him back in. Jirax with a 3-man stun. Very far, we don't allow him to survive, however. He's just making life a little bit more difficult to get out of here. Karka has turned it back off cooldown, but he's not a healthy champion.
These wards are all up in OG's jungle. Look at this. One on the shrine on the left side, one checking out the camp on the left, and one on the shrine on the right. So they're very good coverage of what they are trying to do. OG.
Yeah. Thanks to that observer ward, they saw Jirax jumping towards Roshan. And Nubi will back out just quickly.
Their Roche contest is actually really poor. They don't have Midnight Pulse skilled yet on the Enigma, so they don't actually have enough damage to potentially deal with Roche.
It's that straight up stun, the 4-4-0-1.
4-4-0 is pretty Maybe at one point, right? Usually, just to break trees. But maybe he doesn't want to break trees because of the Monkey King.
Yeah, he actually works against his own team if he does that.
So they find the reward, so that's pretty good for them. You know, you need to be able to flush newbie out of the jungle. Okay, yep. There he goes.
Yeah, and the ward further to the north actually timed out. So the only remaining aggressive ward here, newbie, is the one that's down the shrine. That doesn't help them when they're trying to go for Roshan.
Let's U9's build. Lads rush.
Okay. Well, if you are going to try and run as an OG and try and keep the pressure down, Lads is definitely going to help you with that.
Sometimes blink, however, because the Centaur was in a try on try, so a lot of his XP and farm is going to be taken up. It looks like he's actually still going to blink at a very good timing. 12 minutes if he doesn't die.
At the moment, OG is too busy looking towards Roshan, so KP's got a lot of space on the top lane.
Yep.
Even Rubick is able to farm it. Like, he's halfway down to the bottom lane farming that.
How's our outsider? Like, no, he's going for armlet earlier, but. I assume he's gonna go for Radiance after.
Yeah, he's like gonna go for nothing unusual for Notail. The only thing unusual is just the lane switcher. Anna's a little bit behind, which isn't too terrific, but he's only 600 behind the ball point.
There's Midas.
So
he can also get pulled an egg.
He can also be pulled an egg. No, he cannot. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that to an OD.
Set it up for a black hole.
Oh, yeah. That's actually one of the very rare situations where an ag on OD is something you do want.
It's not the worst thing in the world.
It just seems so odd just like delaying the game with the imprisonment.
Think of the stats, Toby.
Think of the stats.
10 intelligence.
Think of the hero you want to try and focus down. Don't give them time to get abilities back off cooldown.
Oh man, Black Hole and Monkey King Hole? That's nasty.
That's when you wait for. The Leon is already doing the work. Kaka got it nice and early.
The Whistles are actually pretty good at preventing him from jumping the trees too.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Really good maneuvering. Top lane, Kaka returns up here. The observer walks down, the Notown has spray. Would love to get this kill if he can. So on the side of the supply, it still doesn't do the work. End up surviving to the hooked on from KP. He reveals the blink dagger.
Whole team's here.
Yep, pretty much.
Rubick 6 now, so they have to be very careful.
Morphling's rotating up. Monkey King's trying to get here. He TP'd over towards the shrine, so it's going to be our first big 5-on-5 engagement. Stampede is not available at the moment for newbies, so be careful about that. But when you kill off one of the familiars, that's a good start. Well, I'd be forced to resummon already. Monkey King is great, number 2, 3, S4. They're going to be acting defensively. You're free to do it at the moment, unless that actually belongs to the base. The black hole is stolen by the Rubick. He doesn't survive all of the damage. However, there's 9 who's left on the front lines to try and just man-mode this up. And he won't be able to. The imprisonment keeps him out of the fight. And OG do not want any part of this. There's farm on bottom lane, there's farm on mid lane. There's no reason to keep this battle going.
Very risky by 4 by S4. He was on a slither. I really like Garrett losing that fight. He was like off to the southeast. They were trying to approach slowly the trees. It looked like they were hitting the familiars, but they were really looking for the Monkey King that fight. But they couldn't find him, and then he was able to get his own drop. He just died from the atmosphere.
SC again posturing against Adam.
So it might be Rogue time now. Black Hole's down. Wukong command is down. Should be pretty happy about this.
Oh, and he gets both the familiars as well as even bigger. There's no re-summon, and you have to ping out the fact that your purple is there. It's already spotted, so Snooby a little bit dark. They don't understand exactly where that observer was. It's just north. The pit is seeing a fair amount. The Juris can't get close to the pit to rule its intent to that, just throwing his own life away. So they have to let it go. And Snooby just shy of 15-minute mark for playing the first pro shot. Very hard for an OG to stop the road. So, like, what do you mean, not use Black Hole?
And then he just quick pushes and farms and takes fights outside. But as soon as you use Black Hole, they just go inside of Roche. So kind of lose for OG there. But they do have the Alchemist that is the crux of their strategy.
Yep, and he's rapidly approaching that Radiant. You have mentioned aggressive item also appeared on the Earth. So his Blink Dagger is now up and running, combining up with the Vlad and the Aegis. It's very easy for newbie to go full on aggressive now.
I don't think that's going to be able to shut down the Radiant's timing though. I don't really think they cared that much about the Radiant because of the Morphling pick too. You can always ult
it. It turns against the Opulence.
the OD's actually really good at dealing with it, though. I think OD's one of the best heroes at dealing with Morphling Elite. Doesn't have a built-in Hex, but he's one of the best scores to do so.
Because of his ult?
Yeah, the orb. 2-3 shots in. The Alchemy, that thing doesn't have that much HP. It just has a lot of regen, so it really doesn't want to burst.
Rotation in from behind on the top lane as Monkey King counts up. KP, well, they kind of knew Jirax was there, as Jirax will pounce in a little bit deeper, but the tier 1 tower is already gone. The conversions for S4 were doing the work. Tier 1 tower is lost.
Lincoln's first on the Rubick, so he wants to. Oh, sorry, on the Enigma, he's giving the Rubick.
For the only way to stop it. Is anything else that could really trigger it, though, actually?
Okay, that's right.
Okay. Because the Morphling is probably like be sitting there going, I have to adapt to the Enigma.
That's good. The bomb is Lincoln to stop a Black Lotus. The thing about the Rubick, though, is he wants to be.
Jirax preparing to pounce the stone at the ultimate. Kaka is not a healthy man. Rudinine will be able to run out of range of it, however. But it keeps him away from the tier 1 tower, and you expend an MK ulti.
The way the soldiers spawn, or King's Guard, whatever you want to call it, because they actually just cleared an easy path to listen to walk out. Usually you're really hard pressed to find a way to walk out without getting slammed by those.
I love that you remember the terminology. The King's Guard. There goes the tier 1 tower. U9 able to claim that. So more and more map control being opened up for Nubi as they basically make OG's jungle a lot more difficult to move into.
Something they weren't able to do on TV is
ST saw that. ST most definitely saw that.
There's no way to put down trees on.
Oh, that's why Io's on the way up. He'll tether forward, but already he's a slippery little monkey. Thanks, Jack.
Might be time to get a quelling on more. I think he has slots. He didn't cover white.
It's not the craziest idea. He's still trying to finish up his own Lincoln Spear. The Monkey King ready to fight up on the top. You don't have his ultimate available, however, the King's Guard turns off for Kroko. And SC stuns up under the tower. The Monkey King actually got dropped by, I think he actually got dropped by S4. He midnight pulls the trees, the Monkey King hit the ground. So he clipped him off the side. Meanwhile, Anna gets ripped apart by his three heroes in the mid. Stampede to get him in range, and now 40 seconds without the OD.
That was a really good replicate out, though. It looked like it was right above the bottom floor. Could have been a whiff, too. But he's slippery, that one.
Some more.
How's our whiff doing in terms of items? Isn't that worth surprisingly high? 4,300 is pretty good.
Yeah. Well, he's been involved in everything. He's earned to be able to actually pick up some of the kills as well.
So, looks like Nubi aren't able to get that much accomplished between the ults. OT, something that they want to prevent is fighting into
their safe from the
enemy items last game.
Concoction will fly. Obviously, KP can't dodge it, but he can at least get back into a safer location.
Jarrett can't find a good place to stand in the fights. He's always a little bit scared.
He's getting caught out. Okay, now that helps him when he sees KP. KP doesn't have any idea exactly where the Monkey King is, but he can probably assume that someone, that Jirax is in the tree somewhere around there. Jirax is having to keep this a little bit more of a distance, so more than likely, just put down the circle on top of the tower to make it difficult for Nubi to try and find this one, but U9 is ripping apart the tower, and the Alchemist also got copied. They need to bring in OD, but OD is not in position to fight this, so Nubi will get the free tier 2.
Something I really like that Sumail did was turn off his Radiance whenever he thinks he's about to get replicated. He didn't that time, I was watching his toggle. But I think it's very important that you don't leave the Radiance block on the illusion.
But at least he baits out the Stampede.
Radiant.
Ed Barnes! And it's not even belonging to you!
Net worth lead. I don't even think that Radiant earned net worth lead, which is never good if you have an elk. 3,000.
Are they going to try and change it around the smoke maneuver up? But what if they gonk, which really makes this fight more possible? Like,
dragging out the game isn't that bad, though, because they're versus Ursa. Ursa.
They have vision.
Peters off a little bit.
That's actually a really good observer ward up near the tier 2 tower. So it knows that Faith is alone. And it'll also be able to work out the fact that Morphling is up there. The Replicant just would have timed out because he took it for the
for the Alchemist. So they want to try and bring him down.
Gold before he died, and then he's like, oh man, if I die and this fight goes poorly, I'm never gonna get my blink. But he buys back, he steals a pretty important spell, and it's Sandy's Eclipse, and another misfire by OG in the team fight. Oh, looks like KP is a little bit in trouble here.
Yeah, until Udine goes back, and Interact is in trouble. He got 3-1 charges, tries to dodge it by becoming Bach.
That Astral during the black hole, though, that just made them take way too long to kill the fourth one.
Yep. That definitely didn't seem like the perfect lacquer of abilities.
They had the Ghost Scepter on, though. I was like, just fighting with him.
They got jump again on the Udine. Anna now with a 4-star to kill the imprisonment alive. And they nicely hold the Ursa in position. The Enrage will only delay the damage. Now he'll break through with 24 intelligence stolen. That is one dumb bear. 300 mana pool to work with, and Anna, one more orb will do the work. And that's a big one to intercept. Over 500 gone for that one kill. Now on bottom lane, S4 is on the run. The Stampede trying to reduce the distance. So S4 will turn. A quick Midnight Pass will hold him there. Buying time for Gearax to arrive. S4 will put the stream right with his biggest trigger as well. He doesn't have enough life to survive this. But he makes Newbie work for it.
I love that play by S4. He's like, I'm gonna black hole you. And then he didn't even have enough. But they got scared. They were like, it's just a natural reaction when a thing turns around like that. You're like, oh god, he's gonna black hole me. Like,
wait, the timing? Let me check the clock.
He was still a minute up, but he feigned it. I like that. That was good.
Oh. Fantastic player from the Warriors. And you see, Alchemist is number one on network once again. The Enigma is also starting to struggle. Same with that kill for the OD. They're getting back to the top three networks, which same in game one, Newbie were always sitting that little bit further ahead. Obviously game one was a different story because the split push battle that came from OG was a lot stronger. But you do still have elements of that coming in from the Alchemist.
Thursday was able to buy his Dezo before he died, so no gold loss for him. And Roach wasn't up. I think OG had to be able to stop the Roaches. Earth has a lot of trouble scaling if he doesn't get the Aegis. If he gets the Aegis, you know, he has a lot more wiggle room. He doesn't have to buy BKB and defensive items and whatnot. He can kill a lot more people. But once you force him to actually build defensive items and not get kited, he's a lot more trouble.
Well, as we can see, thanks to the awesome PGL, a little simple, as well as the pop-up that came up, Roshan is now only about 45 seconds away from spawning.
And the PD. That's fun. So what ways do they have
PD will wear out before it, though. It's just gonna wear out by the time Roshan spawns.
I don't think that OG is gonna know Roshan spawns though. That's a big problem. Yeah, Monkey King can't get close to the pit because they've been scouting for him constantly and the familiar just died. They don't have Mantis yet on the Alchemist, so no illusion of three scouting from him.
And all their observer wards are in the lanes. Like you actually look at the lanes on both of the safe lanes in the middle, that's where you find the Radiant Ops.
It looks like they're grouping up for a smoke though.
Yeah, I think they understand they have to move in themselves. But they can't take Roshan, right? Like, you're not going to steal it.
They have to just catch him at the right time. Oh, with the BOTs out, actually, was that scouted by the Observer Ward? I'm not actually sure. If they see that, they might be like, well, they don't have
Alchemist. He BT'd onto the lane.
I know. Maybe BOT'd in the lane from mid. It looks like there is.
They're pushing.
Oh, there's the
Excellent. But they're still losing their positioning. Like, yeah, you got the Shrine to go to. But you've just lost your tier 1, your tier 2 counter is important as well. The bottom lane is probably going to end up with a tier 1 being the trade-off. And Newbie, I was actually interested to see like what they would do if they just go directly to Roshan. There's one TP that goes back to mid, and that was the boss thing. And yeah, Ursa is going in.
Who cares about that T1?
Yeah, you really don't.
And they have the EB up on board. So you mentioned like the Lincoln's being popped on the Enigma. That's That's a lot of damage coming out. He's going to be fat. They're actually making a play without the Morbid. Morphling hates it on his own. If you don't hear, we get a solo kill.
Hey, if you can only see the Monkey King. Coming in here, he's going to just pounce him down. He gets lost in the tower. No, he won't. He'll let it go. It's a decent amount of money that gets denied up by SC. On top of that, now they get the bonuses from Roshan. Nubi, you're in a really good position to fight.
Yeah, they can easily tank Black Hole too with the Aegis and or relocate out. Or just Morphling, Strength Morphling. There's a lot of ways for them to deal with
Ruby.
This.
Yeah. There's a lot of options for Nubi in this draft against OG.
They have really good burst now for the Alchemist too. Like, you want to be able to kill him just like, you know, a couple of seconds. Ursa with the Desert can kill him now. The Morphling can also kill him very quickly.
Can you actually pop him quickly? Because those abilities don't seem to synergize too well. Like, you E-Blade pop, you've then got, what,
I think it's one or the other is fine. And then they can just, like, finish him off. They don't have a save for it. Actually, Astral's a pretty good save.
Yeah.
So he turns off his radiance. That's nice. You actually want to turn it off for your Mantle Illusion 2 sometimes, so he doesn't run the Mantle Illusion. So this matchup is not terribly great for the Alchemist.
Monkey King was able to escape a small little battle there with the Rubick on the bottom lane, but it's the mid lane when he's in. Up at the tower, could get Malphus stunned up. Has to enrage early. The Imprisonable will hold it there and don't tell. Well, no extra stuff to arrive, but Uzai keeping life so quickly. Kaka has to actually trigger up Mech to get him out of safety, but just to face in a very awkward spot. S4 as well as Fly catch him out. And then the relocate bringing him. The eye is so much closer back. Kaka will fall as well. This is meant to be Nubi's time to shine, but OG takes the engagement by bringing down both the supports.
U9 is not the tower hitter. They need SCCC to hit the towers. Ursa is just devastatingly poor at hitting towers. You can only hit towers. But, like, you have to get ready to fight again.
Survived on the extra stun to be there from Jira. One time, the only in this position as well. Put down by the trees. Now your Black Hole will come back. All of the Sandstorm fearing will throw the ulti out as well. So, a goner. 1 minute on the sidelines, no buyback available for U9. And OG now taking back-to-back engagements.
So actually one of those games where he had to play it a little bit slower as Urza. I think U9 just really wanted to fight with the Aegis, and he thought that hitting the tower mid would force him to come out, and it surely did, but it put his team in way too far. Without the Wisp, it was just easy Black Hole for them. So yeah, then now they have multiple tools of Kite. You can Atos him to force him to enrage and then just Astral him immediately after. Great Black Hole by Astral. Nothing really that Nubi can do in that play. At least they won't lose SCCC. So now, Ursa's effectiveness in this game is going to be minimal from this point on, I think. Because he's just going to be kind of constantly. And now they have to rely on Morphling a lot more than they would like to.
Can't believe Fly was actually able to TP himself out of that. He found the smallest little tree to get out of.
It's hard to kill Visage. Shotgun doesn't do that much
because
of Gravekeepers.
When he's sitting on sub 50 HP though, you focus everything you've got to stop the engagement at the front line.
The only way of getting good vision though is the Wisp. The Wisp was dead at that point. His spirits were really good at getting vision, but they couldn't find him.
Also, OG. Working for them, the Alchemist up on top. Nubi not really finding that nice powerhouse they were looking for just yet. And we start asking ourselves the question, where's these critical items that come in from Nubi to help them gain control in these fights? Because Nojo is progressing pretty damn quickly. He's got the casual plate man for now, but he's working his way in towards that Octarine.
I think they need BKB on Ursa. Probably the best way for them to deal with the fights.
It was in his quick buy before.
He has to get BKB or else the OD will kite him nonstop. It's just too problematic playing against these items. The Atos and the Force Step and the Astral. You can't get enraged. You can't get Astral during enrage. If you do that, you're just useless afterwards. You can't blink out. You don't have any defensive ability, and you're definitely not going to be hitting anyone because you're just going to die.
KP, silent, hugging the trees, and Monkey King pounced around him but didn't see him. If Jurek jumps up now, we need to jump to the left side to actually see him. He's guessing. He's guessing KP is somewhere there, but he can't smell the centaur of the trees.
I was trying to set up a relocate, but that's going to be a disaster because the thing was there with the black hole. That's a no-go.
Oh, that TP to the guy, as I said.
Okay.
He has a little behind, though.
KP, does he? There's a lot coming up.
Yeah, Observer was behind, but Newbie finds a better angle approach into. They go to the familiars, both sides will connect. And then see, Bumpy and Eva converge, just got a baby, but when he finds the Monkey King, explodes him with a shotgun, and Space looking to bring in the powers of Monkey King. The Rubik, obviously the master of all abilities, but KP, the master of the double hook, stops the attack. With that BKB, Monkey King goes down. So Nortel will fall, Flyers off the run, the TP out from OG, they'll be successful thanks to the space created by the civilians. Newbie will have to camp these up and bring them down, that's exactly what they want. There's no respawn for them as well.
What a great flank by Newbie. Being able to approach from like the east and the south at the same time just made it impossible for S4 to black hole. He had a great midnight pulse, but Urza just raised, turned on BKB, and with those, you actually have a good way to deal with BKBs, except for Black Hole. That's the only way they can actually fight into it unless they just want to run away, which is not going to be easy. Not a good fight to give up for OG.
Yep.
I don't know, actually know how they win a teamfight. Though. Is it all on the Black Hole? I guess they can also just rely on OG killing a lot of itself.
So this definitely helps. TP out, there's KP, the principal hands of that TP. And I'm going to focus one more time. But that won't be enough to survive.
Kickoff flash goes to sleep or worse and worse, I think, because OD has plus 24 amp in this fight. Extra, what, 200 damage on everyone in the vicinities?
Yep. And each time, like, OD gets closer and closer towards level 25, it may take the ability to hold on to that intel even longer.
Roshan gonna respawn soon.
Yeah, judging by our time, and we're still looking at a good another 2, maybe 3 minutes before he's up.
Black Hole's still not used yet. Now Alchemist has most of the items that he needs. They need to be able to find a Wisp in the team fight. And the Illusions of the familiar are going to be doing a important job of scouting. Who's Ursa's main target, though? Ursa?
In the last fight, it was definitely Alchemist he wanted. And he committed everything to bring him down. But maybe it is worthwhile switching your targets towards the OD. Because how much? But then again, who's doing more work? And you got to fear the OD going into later part of the fight if you're not focusing him at the start. Intel's going to increase and increase.
They have to kite the BKBs on OG. I think that's the most important thing. If they can kite both BKBs, the Morphling and the Urza, they can actually turn around with the fight. But if they don't, then they're going to lose one or two cores during that fight, or the Enigma.
So you're happy to let the side of the fight go because OD can't steal the intel from the core.
Well, if you can get a big back hole, you start the fight, but I don't think they're going to be able to do so. They had a lot of trouble just getting a jump.
They saw the bucket kick. They slapped him down. We'll just drag him back up again. So Zero, he was exploded before the last fight began. And now he'll go down for 43 seconds. And this is when Roshan's up at about a minute time.
Really good warning, though, by Newbie. Monkey King, he's been dying a lot. He died in a top T2 fight immediately after he casted his ultimate. Newbie is doing a fantastic job of just annihilating him at the start of the fight. They don't even have to commit that many spells to him, too. It's like an EB, maybe a blink and an overpower of the Ursa. Nothing huge.
Well, he's not tanky. It's the downside, right, of the Monkey King. If he can't survive, he can't keep his ulti down. Compared to other heroes like the Earth Spirit, which Newbie banned out in the first phase of this game.
Centaur's going for hard again over to Scepter. So, Scepter really good, I would say, for multiple reasons. Not only the damage reduction, he can actually run over the freeze, too.
Out of their faith. He'll blink up.
Wow.
His Observer was sort of coming. He knew what was happening, but the stuns are coming in. It's not going to be enough for Fate, even with a 3-man stun.
Still a smoke off for a Rubik kill.
Yeah, but like it lets him have Roshan while Rubik is down.
Fly is inside the pit.
Yep. Roshan just spawned. That mass ping is coming out from the Rubik. He knows. He knows what's going on. SD is going to jump himself down. Wait for him. He's going to have a down there. Here, and the ballistic
plus the extra illusions of the Alchemist.
Wow.
A triple kill for Ana. But Faith is back to the world of the living. Not sure what he can do, but it's enough. Maybe push OG away from the pit.
That was ridiculous amount of damage for SMU's clip. Oh my god. 18 hits with Arcane
damage now. Let's see it again. You can see it brewing. Like, S4 lets this one rip, and as it's like, okay, okay, I'm still good. I'm still good.
I really like the item choice of Aethos, though. It makes his life a lot easier. It prevents the Morphling from being able to wait for him, and that's just so many seconds.
He had 32 when he flipped strong.
That's crazy how he was able to do that fight. Yeah.
So, OG, they are going to go to Roshan. No one from Ruby's going to buy back for this. They just have to let it happen. There's nothing Ruby can do to stop them, even with their good vision. To the south and the east, which is close enough for the fight. Everybody in that stage.
Yeah. I actually think Axel
is now faint is actually kill over on the Rubick. Faith multiple times being picked off, but now with OG having an Aegis the Immortal, they can push up the mid and do quite a significant amount of damage.
I like how they just ignore Ana in a lot of these fights. That's how it seems to be. You focus on Ana in the early game, and in the later game he just does whatever he wants. His positioning's also just been incredible though. Like, he was on the high ground, protected by the Enigma black hole, however brief. The threat of it was still big enough for that no one actually approach.
Oh, Kaka needs to turn the target. He's got one. I mean, back towards the mid. That tier 2 tower is toast, and it's really up to Nubi now. They have to tighten the ship. There's to be too many slide pickoffs for OG of Age to get. The Morphling needs time to be more powerful as well. So far, I haven't really felt his influence. It's been more looking towards the Ursa. And the Ursa's still sitting at the fifth highest net worth on the field.
It's a big problem because both of them had to build BKBs, whereas nobody on OG does. So they're doing a lot more damage in the fights. BKB and Lincoln's impossible to stack black hole.
Love how, too, like, you hold to your BT for keeping your armlet. You traded out his armlet for the cheese on Notel. Well, that's a nice little start pick for us. Rubik coming into this fight. Able to steal chemical raid. Fable to slow down the pressure. CN3 tower still taking good damage. They're coming back mid lane. As well, there's a little bit more push being applied by the Morphling. Enough to make OG retreat. So Nubi's not forced into a heavy engagement. But Uno would love to have one. G-Rex has to go through the tree line. Stampede giving him the movement speed. G-Rex TPing out, and Nubi can't work out where.
Life of an Ursa. You always want to fight. No one wants to fight you until like 40 minutes in. And you just get kited constantly.
That's another Stampede though. Another one. Like, it's going to take not that long for it to come off cooldown.
Okay, he didn't get hard, thank god. Definitely need a Scepter. Scepter is the only way to deal with Black Hole, and it's great at killing Monkey King. You run over trees, knock the trees down, kill him. Because he's always up in the cliff area and whatnot. And he needs to be able to protect the Morphling of the Earth, because they're doing way more damage than he is. If you get Heart as a Centaur, you're just pretty much giving the OD more in. And he's happy to trade, like, return. His return is not terribly great here at all. I guess it kills the birds, but birds are probably the least of your concerns.
Tier 2 tower's gonna now go down, so Nubi, they want to defend their base, but they're already doing the prep work. Bottom lane's pushing in quite nicely, the middle lane's being pressured by the Io, even though Visage Familiars are making that a little bit more difficult. And the Monkey King, a great observer ward sitting inside the base. They see Faith, and potentially Drex just off to the very good of Faith. A little bit more difficult to kill off. And SC also returns to the fight.
They could set up with a big blink black hole, but if they slightly miss it, or if like Wisp is tethering and shrining up at the same time, people are just not gonna die. I think it's super risky to fight inside the base close to the shrines.
That observer will go scattered out. As Monkey King pounced away, he should be instantly pinged, so they understand that. I think they have Sandler Ward sitting on the top side of the base. Either that, or they just thought, hey, Monkey King's there.
I think they're just pinging out Monkey King so they can get some more split push on the map.
Alright. 25 gold for the Aghanims over on Centaur.
Ooh, Ag's up on Rubick.
So, Ag Rubick, Ag Centaur. A lot of negates now to damage the OG. He's looking to pump down the very, very start.
Ag Rubick is a big deal, so he can deal with a Blink and Enigma. He can just spell steal once to pop it and then spell steal twice through the BKB. So that's kind of important. Ag, Aurora Centaur, already talked about that.
Now Enigma actually has two of them. He's got Refresh for all.
He's also going to have an Ag soon. I saw Alchemist was really close to finishing. So, yeah,
are,
right
are
now,
you actually going to prioritize?
I think you give him to Enigma. Blink Black. From his point of view, Blink, BKB, Lincoln's Black Hole is unstoppable.
Unless they consider it. S4 is hovering around him. Yeah. Unless they consider the OD imprisonment as the setup for the
no
call.
Way.
Hey, you mentioned it before, man.
It's like a
flag in it.
I
there
would
it is. It's
say you give it to Moonshard. I think Moonshard's even more priority than either Axe. I think you get Moonshard and OD before any of those.
Well, Legacy Mall now get this recoin. So they only have the cheese left now, OG on no doubt. Anubi still has their base intact, so again, we're going to be approaching roughly the hour mark to try and complete this game.
Carry next Roshan though. I think Newbie know they have to take it, whereas OG they're pretty comfortable with
now. Yeah. But having the Aghanim Scepter on KP makes this next fight really, really good for Newbie. Their sustain has become 10 times better. Obviously, they still need to kill the OD, or else OD is like, okay, well, you can sustain, but I'll continue to steal your intelligence.
I think Wisp actually needs to stay alive in the fight. He's the one that's going to be talking people off after saving some clips, maybe relocating people out of Black Hole. And he is.
Well, that's not a great little confidence boost at this point.
A lot is on you, Kaka.
I got so much to do with that, like, myself.
It's kind of similar to Patriots in the last game.
Yeah.
He needs to do a lot, but with very few items and just a very squishy hero.
Man, there's so much pressure on both supports. Like, we talk about, like, just Fate getting picked up before Roshan happened previously. Stampede being used to try and save him. A moment like that sort of actually cost you all the advantages you needed going into Roshan. Not to mention being a man down. But the Morphin's getting bigger and bigger. A fresh Scotty has now arrived for him. Oh, jump up from Jiren. Careful. And S4 steals Nimbus Rune. There's a little bit more support. Consumption split up. Who knew it? Blinked away quickly, did not want to get caught out in these fights, but Nubia is still being very visible. Those two observed wards, okay, the one in the mid lane just timed out, they pinked out saying, oh guys, we realized we were visible the entire time.
If they can't get too close to the Roshan, they're going to lose the game. I think they have to be able to approach that area somehow. Smoke, gem, like any of these items to regain control of that area. I think having another Aegis on OD is potentially game losing.
Yeah. Jirak scribbled out the top lane. I think he wants that lane pushed all the way up towards the tower. Thanks to the reversal, both lanes still sitting up there from Nubi. And it could just be enough to keep Nubi away from Roshan.
The smoke immediately pops. No kill. They know that one's real, but.
Oh, S4 double damage. He can look sick while he blinks in. Alright, there's your jump. Again, it's Fate. The sacrificial lamb. And they're getting there. He's the new one.
No, you're not.
That Rubick is dead for a full minute, and they start creep skipping out. That's what NC does. Keep the creep waves away, keep OG running behind themselves and not pressuring out. And he knows he's safe. As long as you got the replicate, you're okay.
They have the Hex now on OD. That's
yep.
A big problem. Very, very big problem. Because now, like, the BKBs can kind of be countered. They can just blow up the supports like that with very little counterplay, and Nubi are falling further and further behind in terms of items.
What's out getting next? Still a lot of gold.
You can buy up that moonshot if you're looking for it.
Yeah, you can also get an AC or something like that. Butterfly, I think Butterfly's really good too. Because Ursa can't hit through that at all.
And he wants to go fast enough to not a little bit of trouble. D-Boy off the ground. He's attacking the KP. That's the critical hold him inside. Will it be enough for the KP forward? The Durham Blade not trying to keep himself alive. KP will fall in a huge amount of time on the sideline. 80 seconds. There was no relocate save out. There was nothing like that. And OG, they could go in. No Stampede, no Centaur. Or they can take Roshan.
OD is
and he's not up yet.
So much. I really like how he saved the Astral Fort Stampede too, knowing that was his only way out. Despite FCCC's best efforts. So now they're stuck in this position. They can't even get close to Roche. Like, that's just not even a thing.
Yeah. They have to wait. They have to wait for OG to come to them and then get a better position. No telling if they're going to expose Faith. Well, he's only ever going to get really chemical rage from that Alchemist.
Blade, man. Blade does a little surprising. It's not great versus Ursa because of his enrage. Yeah, he has it on Alk, and then a lot of the times, like, Morphlings will come with their shotgun and waveforms, or their Morphling during the waveforms, so you're not doing that much damage. But it's still makes them how they want to approach the fights. Another way to deal to force out an enrage out of the Ursa.
Dude, you really need to get some vision on the map. Like, their observer ones are so deep on the OG side, they're watching around the secret shop as well as just south of the Ancients. So they see when OG fall back, but right now OG are very happy to be aggressive. They've only got like another 10, 20 seconds before Roshan's going to spawn.
The thing is, they see them, but they can't do anything about it. Yeah. Kind of was mentioned, you have to win a teamfight in order to win the game. And when you have Enigma, you generally have the better teamfight, unless you have some way to the Rubick deal with it, like Rubick or just stronger teamfight, you know, bit more big AoE ultimates, but
the observer one sees everything from OG.
They need a gem.
And they just put their own observer one on top of the sentry, one's already down, so no tell, will reveal himself, cost will fly up, SC's gonna get hit by that as well. So OG, they lost the vision, the ward was dewarded. So we just kind of wrap around into multiple areas. It's a little bit further up towards the tower. KP and Kaka trying to retreat. There's no tier 2 tower to be really protected on. Remember that Agatha standing above Kaka. Kaka and Kaka and Kaka. It's a black hole. We can get a 3! The projectile is here! It's going to be taken down! And he's going to be a lot to work with. Give it 3 levels of mana. Another black hole. You can steal and return the 7-3 attack. Come on, for the jungle arrives. And so will Anna. A buyback in from the Ursa, but it's desperation now from Nubi. They're down to heroes. They don't understand because Central cannot buy back. So we're coming up, attack the tier 3 tower, hit the rocks as well. They've been hit, they can push for one.
Oh.